Look at that tail all corkscrewed off there. Look at that tail all corkscrewed off. Bump, 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 bump. Oh, get up. Yeah, she's looking for a way to get away from the bit. That's okay. Bump her a little bit. Bump, bump, bump. Yeah, she's listening to it. Ho. Ho. There's that head down trying to evade the bit. Okay, she stopped. That's good. I pitch her slack. Yeah, she's upset. She's got her tail all corkscrewed. All right, I'm going to try to bump her backwards. Back. Good girl. Yeah, she's not liking that bit. Too bad. Back. Bump, 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 bump. Bump, 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 bump. Good girl. She's looking to me for some help. She's backing up good, though. Back up again. Ho. All right, get up. Walk on. Go on. Atta girl. I'd rather have her head down like that than up. She'll get used to it here in a bit. All right, but walk on. Walk. You can walk and poop. Come on. That's better. Good girl. Okay, she's got plenty of room between her and the fence. I'm going to turn her. Bump, 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 bump. Send her out. Give her some walk on. Okay, now she's close to the fence. Now, okay, she curled away from it. Turn her the other way. Bump, 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 bump. Drive her out of it. Bump, bump, drive her out of it. There we go. There we go. She's doing good. She's doing good. I'm just letting her wander around. Bump, 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 bump. There we go. Bump, turn, bump, turn, bump, turn. Now she's stalled out. Over here. Yep. Walk out of it. Continue the turn. Had to give her a little impulsion. This is the difference between Missy and Al. Al didn't know anything about the ropes, so they were pretty much of a motivator. Missy is sacked out to ropes and hobbles, so it's hard to get her motivated sometimes. That's why the training whip is laying right here. Walk on. Let her keep mouthing that bit. Her mouth will quiet down after a while. Maybe not today, but it will. Okay, I'm going to turn her toward the camera. Bump, 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 bump. Drive her out of it. Get up. Good girl. See, she's right up against the fence now, so I have to bump her to the inside first. Bump her to the inside. Give her some room to turn, and then bump her all the way around. Get up. Walk out of it. Atta girl. Keep going. Very good. Very good. Keep her going. It's okay. That's okay. She's doing fine. Bump her to the inside a little bit. Get her away from the fence. And then turn her. Bump, bump, bump. Bump, bump, bump. Drive her out of it. Go on. Get up. There we go. There we go. Oh, good stop. I'm gonna try to square her up, get her between the lines. There we go. I'm gonna give her some slack. Let her mouth quiet down a little bit, let her know she did good. Yeah, I need to give them little breaks like this. Otherwise the bit, when they're first getting used to it, it's way too busy in their mouth. They don't understand where the relief is. Okay, she's looking to me for help. Okay, bump her head around. I'm gonna set the bit, right, left, and then bump, bump, release, bump, release, and I'm bump and release for each step. Don't try to haul her back. If I want to back her all the way across this pan, it's bump, release, and she's feeling it really good. Now she's fighting a little bit. Bump, bump, release, bump, release, bump, release, bump, release, bump, release, bump, release. Everyone's a little step. Each time we ask, we're asking for one more step. Bump, release. Ho. Good girl, Missy. Yeah, very good. Okay, walk on. I didn't want you to go turn that way. There you go, walk on. Drive her a little bit. Ho. Get her square between the lines. Ho! We're gonna try something here. Get your head straight. She understands backing up pretty good. I put solid pressure on them. I'm not giving her any release. Not giving her any release. Not giving her any release at all. Keeping solid pressure on it. See, now she's stalled out. She's got her head down. She's stalled out. That's because she can't find where the relief from the pressure is because I'm not bumping. All right, pitch her some slack. Walk her out of it. Walk straight away. Atta girl. It's a lot easier to keep them between the reins when you're in the saddle. So, walk on, come on. All right, take the path of least resistance. All right. I'm gonna turn her to the center of the ring. Get on, get on. No, 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 no. I had to stop her before she got tangled up. She has to listen to my hands, but I didn't ask her to turn all the way around. Walk on. I'm going to turn her to the center of the ring. Walk on. Square her up with the camera. Bump, 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 bump. There we go. Okay, ho. Release. Yeah, she's gone back to putting her head down and playing with that bit. But remember how she eventually stalled out when I put the steady pressure in her mouth, pulling her back? All right, here we go again with just bump, bump, bump. Bump. And get her head square. Bump. There we go. Release. Bump. Release. I should be able to bring her all the way back to me. Bump. Bump. Release. Bump. Release. Bump. Release. Keeping her square. Keeping her between the lines. Bump. She'll get it figured out here after a while. Bump. There, I got her back to all the way. I can reach out and touch her tail from here. Oh. See, she didn't stall out on me. But hauling and putting that steady pressure in there, she knows what it means, but she's going to start to look and say, well, where's my reward for doing this? As long as you keep putting that little bump, release, bump, release, bump, release, that little release in there is reward to the horse. They interpret it as that. And as long as you continue to show them where the relief is, they'll continue to go toward it. When you take it away from them, when they start to expect it, then they'll say, hey, what's in this for me? And that's when they stall out. Okay, Missy, walk on. Good girl. This is her only her second time ever on long lines that I've been doing it. Come on, get up. And the first time was about 3 years ago. when we had an accident, didn't we? Yeah. That's when she ran into my other mare and the two of them wound up with a Sweeney shoulder. Took my mare 2.5 years to recover, and she still favors that leg. Missy's much more recovered. She wasn't hurt quite as bad. Okay, turn her. Drive her out. Driving her out. Good girl. All right, I'm gonna pull her in away from the fence. Keep going. Come on. Come on. Oh, you can walk and poop. Come on. I'll cut her a break. Come on, get up. Get up. Atta girl. Okay, she's away from the fence now. I'll turn her back into it. Bump, bump, bump. Bump. Drive her out of it. Keep taking up the ropes. So she doesn't get tangled up in it. Now, I need to try this a little closer to the camera. Let me bring her back in. I'm going to show you the snaffle action here. When you're turning the horse with direct rein, like we're doing here, bump her again. I'm going to walk past the camera, and I'm going to turn her to the left, hard to the left. Oh, I think she walked past it. Walk her out of it. Turn her hard to the right. Whoops. Hard to right, bring her back, walk her out of it. Ho! Ho! Nope. Back. Back. Bump and release, back. Yeah, she's got her head down trying to get away from that bit. She doesn't like it. Now, pitch your complete slack. Good girl, Missy. Good girl. Oh, you got an itchy spot on your tail, too. You got an itchy spot on your tail. Come here, good girl. Now, what I wanted to explain about using the direct rein on a snaffle, when you're turning her, say you're turning her to the offside, and you've got this direct rein, and you're pulling out here to the side, you think what you're doing is pulling the horse's head around with the bit. What you're actually doing, and that would be having the horse move into pressure. Oh, easy, babe, easy. Into pressure, which is their normal instinctive reaction. All right, but in reality, what she's doing is moving away from pressure, because the pressure you put on this bit goes through her mouth to this O-ring, and this O-ring goes up against her cheek, pushes her cheek, and tells her to move away from pressure, not into it. Time out, phone's ringing, probably my horse trimmer. We need you to turn around. I need you to turn around, honey. There you go. There you go. Good girl. All right, now we're back underway. Yeah, I see him over there. No, you can't put your head down for that stuff. I think we'll get some ivermectin rub on your tail spot there. Yeah. Drive her out. Turn her right, drive her out. Turn her left. Drive her out of it. Bump her left some more. And ho. Ho. Pitch her to slack. Back her up just a step. Back. Bump, 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 bump. There's the step I wanted. Pitch her to slack. All right. Let's go back to what I was talking about on the snaffle. Good girl. Give her a little reassurance and some rest here. Yeah, when you're pulling on this rein, the offside rein, you're not dragging her head around. What you're doing is putting this O-ring flush up against her face. And that's the pressure she's moving away from. All right, hold still. Yeah, I know. I know I'm playing with it. So the adage about teaching them to move away from pressure still holds true when you're training to the snaffle. Now, you don't use a curb bit or a solid mouthpiece bit, and I say either or because of Tom Thumb, which is a broken bit, is still a curb bit. It's still a shank. this is the snaffle your horse needs to be on if it doesn't know how to neck rein. Because when you have a solid bit in their mouth and you're direct reining your horse, that's a good way to get my arm broke. When you're direct reining your horse, that solid mouthpiece that's in their mouth is going to tilt like crazy. So you got one that's resting on the bars, another one that's up against the roof of the mouth. The port is cattywampus and crooked in their face, and it's just an uncomfortable experience for the horse. The idea behind the curb bit is to be able to ride with one hand. That's why you want a horse that's already neck reined. So you can ride with one hand and hold your whiskey bottle with the other, or shoot varmints or wave to your friends or whatever it is you do with that free hand, or rope, that kind of thing. But until you get neck reining installed on your horse, keep them on the snaffle or on a broken bit. And as long as you're doing direct reining, you do not want a solid mouthpiece or a curb bit on your horse. Okay? Let's move off just a little bit more. You're being such a good girl. This good girl. She doesn't know a whole lot. She's, 6 years old now, I think. But her owner didn't want to start her until she was at least 5 or 6. But she's tame as a house cat. And you can actually, the kids get on her and ride her around bareback, but when they ride her, they quote-unquote just let her wander where she wants to go. Move out. And that's why we're working on training her to the bit and letting her know what impulsion's all about and how to listen to hands from the rider. But she's going to be a good little horse. Go on, get up. Get up. Get up. Get up. Okay, I'm going to bump her to the right. Bump, 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 bump. She's listening to it. Okay. Drive her out of it. Bump her back to the left. Bump, 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 bump. Keep up the impulsion. Atta girl. She's trying to walk in a circle now. Here we go. Walk her around a little bit. She's starting to get annoyed that tail's really going. She's used to being a pasture queen. All right. Turn her to the center. Drive her out of it. Get up. Turn her to the center. And drive her straight to the camera. Straight to the camera. She doesn't know what the camera is. So I have to direct her. She's got a lot going on in her mouth. Come on, get up. Walk on. And ho. Good girl. And I'm going to call that a session for her. It's only 15 minutes or so. We can go a little bit longer next time. In fact, next time I'll probably work on her from the saddle, because she doesn't have any indication that she wants to come over backwards to get away from that bit. And even if she did, all I got to do is pitch her slack immediately, get out of her mouth, and she'll settle down. But we'll give her a break. She was starting to crank that tail pretty good. And she's had almost all summer off because it's been so blamed hot and humid down here, plus all the rain. It's just now starting to dry out. But anyway, that's long lining with Missy. Again, I think it's only her second time on long lines and the first time she's had a bit in her mouth in a couple of years that I know of. So I like to work with horses who actually need work. A lot of times you'll see videos, people, well, this is how you do this, that, and the horse is absolutely perfect. Just, oh yeah, that's the result that I want. Well, yeah, they're working with a horse that's already trained. And I like for you to be able to see what may or may not happen when you're starting a horse out, because nothing ever goes like it does in the videos. Never. Unless you're real lucky. But it's always best to start working with a horse when you're doing long lines and you're doing it for the first time. Do it with a horse that already knows how to drive. That way the horse is kind of teaching you how to do it and what it's supposed to look like. So then when you go to hook up to a horse like Missy that's never been on long lines or had a bit in her mouth before, you kind of know what it's supposed to look like, and you have a direction that you want the horse to go in and how to get them there, because you've already worked with a horse that didn't need it. So from that aspect, it's good if it's available. But if not, it's no big deal. Just don't get close enough that you get kicked. If the horse gets upset and starts throwing its head, getting light in the front end, just get out of their mouth and they'll settle right down. Okay? Good girl, Missy. Oh, one more thing. When I'm done here and I take these lines off, I'm going to take the bit out of her mouth. I'm not going to let her walk around with the bit in her mouth so she gets used to it. She'll get used to it, but I want her to get used to it knowing that it's there for a purpose, not just to annoy her. If she wanders around with the bit in her mouth, it's just something for her to chomp on and for her to figure out ways to get her tongue over the top of it. So only leave the bit on there when you're working with your horse. Kind of like only leaving the halter on when you're working with your horse and not turning them out with something they can get caught up in. But don't let them roam around with the bit, and don't lunge them with the bit. Drive them with the bit, ride them with the bit, but do not lunge them with the bit. Just use the long lines. Okay, good girl, Missy. It's a good horse.